Hey guys and girls, welcome to another episode of the Automation / BeamNG Crawloff. Now, today I bring to you the Model 7 Trim 6. Now, the reason why it's called the Model 7 Trim 6 is because I forgot to name it during its construction. Basically, the Model 7 Trim 6 was my attempt at building a Hummer H2. As you can see here, it's got the sort of the rear tail lights of a Hummer, fancy quad exhaust, bling rims. Although the chrome didn't quite come across into BeamNG, which is kind of annoying. The grille did. The grille's chrome. We've got the headlights, we've got the indicators, we've got the truck mirrors, we've got roof racks. So, as I said, it ended up getting named the Model 7 Trim 6 because I forgot to name it. Anyway, first things first, before we do anything, we need to check its road legal criteria. As you can see, we've got indicators flashing on the front. Bit hard to see against that yellow body, but they are indeed there. And we've got them flashing on the rear as well. Okay, because all of the trucks involved in this crawl-off have to be strict legal. And there's our headlights. I'm not sure if I've got fog lights on this, but we'll see what happens. Let's just turn those lights off again. I don't think they're functional, but I'll see. Electrics, headlights, fog light. Yeah, no. The bottom ones aren't functional. I think they might be high beams. So I'll just turn that back off and we'll see. High beam, yeah. There we go. High beams are enabled. All right, let's turn those lights off and let's get up the trail. Remember, with the Crawloff series, we basically take the trucks as far as they can go physically before coming to a complete halt. So, let's drop the tire pressures. First things first, we're going to drop the tire pressures down. So let's see, front tire pressures. Let's go all the way down to 9.5, which is where we usually drop them to. 8.5, 9.5. I'll just slide this one myself. There we go, and we'll hit apply. So that's our tire pressures dropped. We'll lock the diff, we'll drop it into low range. Front and rear diffs are locked. Let's head off. Let's see how we go. Now, I don't know how far this is going to go because those tires really aren't suited for heavy-duty off-roading. And it sort of has a kind of long wheelbase. Already, I've managed to bottom it out. Uh-oh. That's not a good position for the truck to be in. But we're down. I mean, this has got a pretty good frontal approach angle. It's pretty high up. The suspension seems to be working pretty good. But I just couldn't make the wheels any bigger without, you know. Well, we didn't come to a complete stop, but we did get stuck on a rock. No, I'm caught up on the axle back there. Nope, I'm stuck. Finally got grip. Haven't got any grip here. I'm stuck. Not that it can't get fast here. Although, I have a feeling it might be where this thing stops, and it only just got past one point. Look, I'm gonna try two approaches to this, because a certain subscriber of mine complains that I spin my wheels way too much. So I'm going to try his approach to off-roading, which is the slow and steady method. And if that doesn't work, then I'm going to do it my way. So, okay, let's try. Nice and easy. Avoiding wheel slip at all times. Oh, I'm wheel slipping. Nope, didn't work. Do it my way. And we're through. Wow, it actually got up there. I'm surprised. That's it, that traction control's coming off. I want wheel spin. Thank you. Everything works better when you just send it. Oh, look at that. I got out of the river. Cool. I was going to fix the engine. There we go. See, everything goes further when you just send it. Gets more expensive, but it gets further. Back her up. And just send it. The back one. I can see it. It's already... See? It's ripped. Right there. Yeah, we'll just lift it. It's a flat tire. It's not a busted tie rod. So there we go. It's on what? Two points now? Much better when you just send it. Okay. My way's not working. Let's try that certain other person's way. Slow and steady, minimum wheel spin. See if that works. Of course it did. The time where I wanted it to fail is the time it actually succeeded. So let's try the slow and steady. I'm still wheel spinning. Oh, now we crawling. Now we crawling. Minimum slip. Slow progression. Although if I just sent it, we'd be up the top by now. You're kidding me! Slow and steady, and I burst a tire? Really? Yep. I'm gonna pull. There goes the wheel. See, when you do things slow and steady, when you fall, it's more dramatic. Broken left tire, engine's hydro locking, radiator's broken, and we lost two wheels off one side of the vehicle. Alright, back up you get. Come on. Whee! And donk. There we go. Just before you fell. Everyone likes the carnage whenever it happens. Back up we get. Ah, I went too far back. Oh well. That front wheel is busted. Oh, there goes the axle. Oh, we got... Don't ask me how Beam and G physics works, because my axle is completely separated, but I can still steer. And I've got drive. Don't ask me how that's working. Oh, I ended up back where I was before. Back off you get. I know this is not your physical limitations. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna fall off again. Yay! Finally. I've got that on full lock and I am not turning. Ay, ay, ay. Off we go again. Whee! Ow. Back up. Come on. Nope, that's not... Oh, back up. That's halfway up. That's airborne still. And I'm still rolling down the hill. Alright, I'll come back to here. There goes the mirror. How long did it take us to get around that? Oh dear. Forgot about this bit. Oh, I sent it too hard. Oh, broke a wheel. Break a wheel. Face the deal. Up you get again. Oh, I went too far. Oh, I cocked it up. Back up you get. You know what? Let's see if I can go further this time. No, that just puts me all the way back. Okay, oh no! I put us all the way back at the beginning. No! Alright, it's okay. I think I got this. Nope. I want to go that way, and I want to go... Nope. That's looking. Here we go, we're going up. Forwards and up. I want to go that way, and then I want to go up. And then back here. Yeah. This is where we were. But considering I've fallen off here so many damn times, I think we're just going to plonk it right. Ugh. Right on this rock here, I think. There we go. Perfect. I popped a tire already? That's not fair. It's a Hummer. It pops low profile off-road tires all the time. Ooh, flammed Hummer. It literally is too big. Oh, it popped front up. Yep, limiter bang for the win. Let's try the other approach, which is nice and easy. Oh man, off we go again. Yank! Right, let's have a good look here. See what I've got to deal with. I got to pop that front wheel up onto that rock, and then with enough momentum, get the back wheel up and across. Let's try this. That didn't work. That's not working. Mm-hmm. I popped another tire again. Jeez. This truck is having no luck today. It's not so good off-road. I went way too far back. Shoot. Oh, I did it again, guys and girls. I can't believe that. Today is just a cacophony of errors. Oh, I can't believe I did that. Hello. And thunk. Let's do it softly, gently. Are we still going to pop a tire? That's what I want to know. Down we go. Back up. Oh shoot, I did it again. Aye, aye, aye. Went too far back and I'm not sure what's going on. Alright, I'll plonk it here and we'll try again. Ah, we got up that time. Cool. Well, it's definitely not going to make it to the end. Definitely not. I have a feeling it's going to get stuck just up here. That wheelbase and these tires and rims. Wow, managed 5 points pretty easy. In fact, I'm really only going to be honest with you, I'm going to give this 3 stars because it didn't actually make it to the bridge without getting caught badly. Oh, crap. There's a wheel. There's another wheel. Oh, look, I got 2-wheel drive. They're just on completely opposite sides of the vehicle. Back up you get. Doing. Great place to put a rock right up against the prop shaft. Golly. Oh. The Tire Chewer. That's what it's going to be known as. The Tire Chewer. I'm now going to name this thing The Tire Chewer. I don't think we're getting up here. This is about as far as this thing's gonna go. It just has the wrong wheelbase. Look, can we just admit right here, right now, that low-profile off-road tires don't work? And can you stop putting them on off-roaders? You know, off-roaders are supposed to have chunky off-road tires. This doesn't. This is set up like a Hummer, and it ruins its off-road capabilities. That is it. That is as far as this thing is going to go. I'll do it my method, which is just full-on send it, and we'll see how we go. But I have a feeling this is as far as we're going to get. Okay, traction control is off. Let's pop some tires. Limiter banging's fun. We're not getting out of here, guys and girls. Let's just face it. Nope. Oh, hang on. Just found some grip. Oh, just when I thought it was over. Maybe we're going a little further then. Like that's gonna work. Well, guys and girls, I think I'm gonna call it here. Literally, this thing has driven further than it should have, because technically it got stuck all the way back over there. So I am only gonna rate the Tire Chewer, as I'm now gonna call it, the Model 7 Trim 6, 3.5 stars, because it really really honestly struggled before the bridge. Guys, if you've liked this content, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. By all means, if you want to stay up to date with the series, hit that subscribe button, whack the bell on, And I will catch you guys in the next episode. But 3.5 stars for our Model 7 Trim 6, aka the Tire Chewer. So I'm just going to note that in my little journal. And I will catch you guys in the next adventure on the Automation / Beam and G crawl off. Until then, I will say bye for now. See ya.